Dear all, welcome to this video. Let's see in a very short time the main features inside Flash Integro's VSDC, a great video editor completely free to use. Visit our YouTube channel and our official website to get good tips, free tutorials, and participate in exclusive giveaways. VSD is a great product with a complete set of tools and features to create amazing videos and slideshows in a non-linear workflow very similar to Adobe After Effects. In this video, we are going to use the free version, but you can upgrade to VSDC Pro for hardware acceleration, advanced effect mask, chroma key, and motion maps to make objects move. The startup page of VSDC is divided into two, showing several tips and articles from the official VSD website at the bottom and different ways to start on top. For example, you can use video and screen capture to record videos from your webcam or your desktop and create slideshow to build slideshows quickly and easily, setting the video properties first and then dragging and dropping media and ready transitions directly inside the wizard window. This slideshow will be imported on the main workspace to be edited and rendered as we will see in this video. To start from a new empty project, go to blank project. Set its name, metadata, and basic properties, choosing any ready template from device and resolution. And then adjusting the video width and height, its frame rate, and its audio frequency and channels. When clicking on Finish, the new project gets open on the main workspace, showing the ribbon on top and several windows on both sides. If you miss any of these, you can reopen it by going to the View tab. At the bottom, you have the timeline, which is the place where you can edit and create your own project through time. This gets measured in seconds or in frames when clicking on the watch icon above. Each VSDC project is made by independent pieces of video called scenes, and each scene is composed by several elements called clips, which can be images, videos, sound files, but also text and geometrical shapes. On the timeline, all of these clips are shown as colored blocks collected inside rows called layers. To add media files on the timeline, just drag and drop these files onto it directly. These show their file name or useful video thumbnails through time that you can check better by either enlarging the layer rows or increasing the zoom level with the zoom slider on the left. You can also hover over these clips to get more information and retrieve these on the resources window. The preview on the center shows the content of the timeline where the red playhead is. You can move it and check different frames by clicking or dragging on the timeline. Whereas use the spacebar key for a quick playback with sound, or the green eye button for a full and complete preview. Next to such button, you can also adjust the preview quality. In case multiple clips overlap in time, their order of visibility is set by the order of the layers they're into. All clips inside the top layers are shown in front of all the clips placed on layers lower in position. This order can be changed by going to the Edit tab and using the up and the down arrows. On the left side, you can also hide the eye icon to disable the layer content from the preview and the final video until you click on it again. Now, let's see how to modify clips. Click on any clip to select it, then drag it to move it in time within the same layer or in another one. One single layer can welcome multiple clips which cannot overlap. Click and drag the clip edges to adjust its length. If you shorten it, you cut part of its video and audio content. If you extend it, only the last video frame is used with no audio content. To cut, copy, and paste any selected clip, just right-click on it. Remember to use Ctrl and Z to undo any action if you make mistakes. You can also edit the basic appearance of any visual clip from the preview itself. When selecting the interested clip from the timeline or directly on the preview, a dashed contour shows up around it. You can move and place the clip by clicking and dragging within it, scale it by using the black nodes, holding down the Shift key to save its aspect ratio, and drag outside the contour to rotate. Inside the Edit tab, you can also find auto-alignment and auto-scaling options if you need. If multiple clips overlap, you can use the lock button from the left to block any clip and make it unselectable. This way, you can select and edit the interested clips much easier. On the right side, you also have the Properties window to adjust specific options for the selected clip, such as speed rate on videos and volume level on audio files. Next to it, the Basic Effects window applies advanced color correction and grading, adjusting brightness, contrast, RGB colors, saturation level, and tone curve. Other great editing tools are collected inside the Editor tab on top. With the clip selected, use cutting and splitting to trim videos and audio, or the simpler split into parts to split the clip where the red playhead is placed in time. You can also enable the crop tool to crop images and video frames. In addition, you can go to Add Object to add geometrical shapes and text on your project. You will also be asked to set where to add the object on the timeline and how. By default, these are added as new independent clips inside the Current Timeline tab that is open. For example, if the timeline is open on a scene, the object is added inside it as an independent clip. Whereas, if the timeline is open on a clip by double-clicking on it, the child object is added inside such parent clip and follows it in case the parent clip moves or gets resized. Use line, rectangle, and ellipse to drop lines and geometrical shapes inside the current scene or clip where the red playhead is. You can use the Properties window to adjust properties or the Editor tab above it to set contour and filling colors with pen and brush color. Use text or tooltip to add pieces of text without or with any contour. Just click and drag on the preview to drop the next contour and type in by double-clicking on it, or use the Properties window. On the Editor tab, you can adjust the text color and the background color as brush color, the contour color, and everything regarding the font family, style, size, and paragraph. In the same way, you can go to Video and Audio Effects to add outstanding effects, which are applied as effect clips inside the selected parent clip, starting from where the red playhead is. So the placement in time and the length of the effect clip state when and for how long the special effect should be applied on the parent media clip. Among the effects, you can also have visual and audio transitions used to introduce and end any clip content with special effects. When inserting, you can choose either to scene end or from scene begin. To add the transition in the end or at the beginning of the current clip, and then edit these as standard clips. Once your project is finished, go to Export Project above to render it. On the center, you can take a look at the project video and audio properties used, and at the bottom, get a comparison between the actual properties under Input and the ones chosen for the rendering under Output. Above, select the template to start from for either PCs, iPhones, Android devices, or consoles. At the bottom, use Change Name to set video name and destination folder, and edit profile to customize your video codecs with height, quality, frame rate, and audio properties. To start rendering, use Export Project on top. VSDC will render the whole content of all your project scenes until the end of the last clip in time. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to check out our YouTube channel and our website for extra tips, tutorials, and much more.